Welcome all to AK Bio Lecture Series. In the previous classes, we discussed the process of oogenesis and spermatogenesis in detail. Next, we will discuss the details of how the fertilization takes place. Before that, you must know about the various layers around the egg. These are the layers of the egg in general. And in this, cortex is the only layer which is positioned inside the egg plasma membrane. And the plasma membrane is the layer as same as any other cell. And all the other layers listed in this slide will discuss in detail in coming slides. When the development of ova into an egg takes place inside the follicle, several layers of cells positioned around the developing egg. For the quick understanding of the layers around the egg in human, see this diagram. You must have an idea about the terms in the diagram, such as the primordial follicle, the primary follicle, the secondary follicle, tertiary follicle, ovulating follicle or graafian follicle, and corpus luteum. If you don't know these terms and the characteristics of each stages, then I recommend you to watch previous videos about follicle development and oogenesis classes. Here in this slide, this is the diagrammatic representation of egg structure of C. archin. And here you can see the plasma membrane. So outside the egg cell membrane or plasma membrane, you can see a structure which is composed of a fibrous mat called extracellular matrix. In the case of invertebrates, not vertebrates, in the case of invertebrates, and in non-mammals, the structure is usually called the vitelline envelope. Here you can see the vitelline envelope just outside the plasma membrane. And the vitelline membrane or vitelline envelope is a structure surrounding the outer surface of the plasma membrane of an ovum. So, in this diagram, it is very clearly represented the vitelline envelope, which is positioned just outside the plasma membrane. Here also, in the first diagram also, you can see the plasma membrane here and the vitelline envelope here. So, first layer is plasma membrane, then outer to the plasma membrane, you can see the vitelline envelope. Note that this vitelline envelope is present in invertebrates and in non-mammals. In the case of mammals, this structure, that means this fibrous mat extracellular matrix structure, is of thick extracellular matrix called zona pellucida. So, in the case of mammals, you cannot see this vitelline envelope, but you can see a structure that is thicker than the primitive vitelline envelope, that is called the zona pellucida. So the zona pellucida is a glycoprotein layer. So it is composed of glycoproteins. The zona pellucida is composed of glycoprotein. And surrounding the plasma membrane of mammalian oocytes. So, zona pellucida is a glycoprotein layer that is surrounding the plasma membrane of mammalian oocyte and is secreted by, and the glycoproteins of the zona pellucida is secreted by both the oocyte and the ovarian follicle. And the structure of zona pellucida, that is the glycoprotein layer, that is which is secreted by the oocyte, developing oocyte and the ovarian follicle, is first appears in unilamellar primary oocyte. So here you can see the primary oocyte. This is the first stage, this is second stage. The first stage is primordial follicle. Here you cannot see the zona pellucida layer. In this primordial follicle stage, you cannot see the zona pellucida layer. But in the case of primary follicle, you can see the zona pellucida very first time. And what is the function of this vitelline envelope in the case of invertebrates and in non-mammals, and the zona pellucida in the case of mammals? What is the function of this layers? Means the vitelline envelope and the zona pellucida. This is often involved in species-specific sperm egg recognition. So the vitelline envelope and zona pellucida involved in species-specific sperm egg recognition. So let's discuss about the vitelline envelope. It contains several different glycoproteins. You can see here the egg plasma membrane, means this is the egg plasma membrane, and here you can see the vitelline envelope. This vitelline envelope is the outer layer of the egg plasma membrane, and this vitelline envelope is composed of glycoproteins. So some glycoproteins are exclusive for the vitelline envelope, and some glycoproteins are present as the extensions of membrane glycoproteins from the cell membrane. So here you can see some connections between the egg plasma membrane and the vitelline envelope, isn't it? So these are the extensions, these are the simple extensions of membrane glycoproteins from the egg plasma membrane that is connected with the vitelline envelope. And these are called the proteinaceous posts. So proteinaceous posts that adhere the vitelline envelope to the cell membrane. So what is the function of these connections that adhere, that helps to adhere the plasma membrane, egg plasma membrane, with the vitelline envelope? TEM is perivitelline space. Here you can see the plasma membrane. This is inside of region of the egg, and here you can see this reddish line is the plasma membrane, and outer membrane, outer to the plasma membrane, you can see the vitelline envelope or zona pellucida. Here you can see the zona pellucida. So this is the diagrammatic representation of the egg of mammal, isn't it? Because this zona pellucida, not the vitelline envelope. So in the case of non-mammals and invertebrates, you can see here the green colored region will be the vitelline membrane. So the space between this plasma membrane and the vitelline membrane or zona pellucida is called perivitelline space. So this white region is perivitelline space. Okay, this white region is perivitelline space. I hope you are familiar with this diagram. It means the development of egg and follicle, means folliculogenesis and oogenesis. And here you can see this, the mature oocytes, the graafian oocyte, and with andrum. So I think you are familiar with these terms. So of course this is the diagrammatic representation of mammalian egg, and in the case of mammalian egg, it is also surrounded by a layer of cells called Cumulus. What is the function of the cumulus cells? It nurtures the egg. So here you can see the egg or oocyte. This is the follicle, isn't it? This blue color cells are part of follicle. So the cumulus cells nurtures the egg at the time of its release from the ovary. After this stage, you can see the process of ovulation. So the ovulated egg is also surrounded with this layer, isn't it? Here also you can see this layer with the cumulus cells. So it nurtures the egg at time of its release from the ovary. So this is the ovulation process, and during this process the cumulus cells nurtures the egg inside the cumulus cells, and this layer is made up of the ovarian follicular cells. So this cumulus cells is nothing but the ovarian follicular cells, and the innermost layer of cumulus cells, you can see the several layers of cumulus cells here. It is represented with two layers, but in the case of normal case, this multi-layered. So the innermost layer of cumulus cells, the innermost layer here in these two layers, the second layer, that is near to the oocyte, that is the innermost layer of cumulus cells, that immediately adjacent to the zona pellucida is called corona radiata. So this innermost layer is called corona radiata. So here you can see this blue line is not distinguishable here. This layer is called zona pellucida. We already mentioned that the zona pellucida layer will be first appeared in the primary oocyte stage itself, isn't it? So the cumulus cells, which are very much near to the zona pellucida, is called corona radiata. So we discussed about the vitelline envelope and the perivitelline space, isn't it? So next is egg jelly. In this picture, you can see here the plasma membrane, and the outer to the plasma membrane, you can see the vitelline envelope, and in between the plasma membrane and vitelline envelope, the space is called perivitelline space. And so in many type of eggs, you can see an extra layer called a jelly layer. It is also called egg jelly. Again, it is composed of glycoproteins. So again, it is composed of glycoproteins. In the case of vitelline envelope itself, we mentioned that it is also composed of glycoproteins. And what is the function of jelly layer? Jelly layer is used either to attract or to activate sperm. So what is the function of jelly layer? Attract or activate sperm. But in the case of vitelline envelope, what is the function of vitelline envelope? It is for species specific sperm egg recognition. The next layer is cortex. I said that cortex is the only layer that is present inside the plasma membrane. So this is beneath the plasma membrane of the egg, and it is stiffer than the internal cytoplasm. Of course, the egg, inside the egg, you can see the cytoplasm, the region which is very much near to the plasma membrane. The cytoplasm, which is located near to the plasma membrane, is stiffer than the internal cytoplasm. So this is the internal cytoplasm, and this is outer cytoplasm or external cytoplasm. So in this region the cytoplasm is stiffer than the internal cytoplasm. This region contains high concentration of globular actin molecules. So at this region you can see this rich in the actin molecules. In the background you can see here the egg cell membrane, that is plasma membrane. So this is the plasma membrane, and this outer layer is vitellin envelope, and this is the cytoplasm inside the egg. But the region of the cytoplasm that is near to the plasma membrane is stiffer than the internal cytoplasm, and thus that layer is called the cortex. So this region is rich in actin microfilaments. Here you can see the actin microfilaments. What is the function of these actin microfilaments during fertilization? Here you can see the presence of spame here, and some spames, one of the spame is fused with the egg itself. And during fertilization, the actin molecules at cortex polymerize to form long cables of actin microfilaments, and the microfilaments are necessary for cell division. After fertilization, the zygote will divide into multiple cells, isn't it? That process is called cleavage. So these microfilaments are necessary for the cleavage. Then another function of this is the first function of microfilaments or actin microfilaments, and the second function of microfilaments is they are also used to extend the egg surface into small projections. Here you can see some projections, isn't it? So these actin microfilaments are used to extend the egg surface into small projections called microvilli. So these projections are called microvilli. What is the function of the microvilli? Microvilli aid spame entry into the cell. Other than the actin microfilaments, you can see the cortical granules in the cortex area or cortex layer. So within the cortex are the cortical granules, and these cortical granules are nothing but these are the vesicles or vacuoles which are derived from the Golgi apparatus. So these are Golgi derived structures, and so these are the vesicles which contain some substances, and which are the substances? The proteolytic enzymes, mucopolysaccharides, adhesive glycoproteins, hyaline proteins. So these are the cortical granules, and inside the cortical granules you can see these materials. Okay, so these cortical granules are present inside the egg, isn't it? So they are homologous to acrosome. Here you can see the acrosomal vesicle of the spame. And what is the function of these cortical granules? It prevents the multiple entry of the spame. So these granules, these cortical granules, which are located very near to the plasma membrane, isn't it? Which is present in the cortex region of the cytoplasm, and it is very much near to the plasma membrane. Once a single spame is entered into the egg, what will happen is that this cortical granules fuses with the plasma membrane and release the components, that is the proteolytic enzymes, mucopolysaccharide, adhesive glycoproteins, hyaline proteins, into the perivitellin space, and prevent the entry of other spames into the egg. So it prevents the polyspamy condition. The next layer is the plasma membrane. Plasma membrane is the membrane enclosing the egg cytoplasm, and it regulates the flow of specific ions during fertilization. So this is the plasma membrane, and what is the function of plasma membrane? It regulates the flow of specific ions during fertilization, and it is capable of fusing with the sperm cell membrane. Of course, this plasma membrane of the egg fuses with the plasma membrane of sperm during the process of fertilization. So this is the electron micrograph picture of the egg. Here you can see the ovum and the outer layer of the ovum, that is the zona pellucida. It is the outer layer to the plasma membrane, and here you can see the polar body and the cumulus cells, that is the follicular cells that nourishes the for developing ova or released ova after ovulation. And the so that is the end of different layers of the egg. Hope you understood the topic well, and thank you.